Okay, hello friends. We are back here with the new one video, that is LLR parsing part 1 or LLR parsing, you can see. We will see LLR parsing table construction in this video only. Yes, this is the CLR1 parsing table. As you can see here, this is nothing but the CLR1 parsing table as we have used or use the same table. Same example we are using. By making some changes in this table, we are going to construct the LLR1 parsing table. CLR1 parsing table means you have done most of the work of parsing table construction related to LLR1 parsing table. By doing some changes, I will explain this video. Before moving further my explanation, I request you all that is you should know that is what is LR1 item, what is canonical LR1 items, how to construct parsing table for CLR1. So please refer my previous video of CLR1 parsing. The link of the previous video is given, or CLR1 video link is given the description of this video. So I hope if you refer that previous video so that you will get the better idea how to construct table, how to construct state transition diagram of CLR1. If you remember that example, I can show you here again. This is nothing but the previous video where we have learned the CLR1 parser, LR1 items and canonical collection of LR1 items. What are the LR1 item? That is LR0 plus look ahead, means what? Whatever the grammar is given, that is first on right hand side a dot is present in the production rule, and that is nothing but your LR0 plus whatever the extra symbols available are nothing but your look ahead symbols. Okay, these are nothing but your canonical LR1 item. Combinedly, it is known as a LR1 item. And we have seen one example with this grammar. And this state transition diagram we have constructed in previous video. And afterwards, we have generated one table regarding to this video. And with this state transition diagram, this table is nothing but your CLR1 parsing table. Okay, so same table here we are using in this video for constructing LLR1 parsing table. As you can see, it is the same table we are using and same example we are using. But what are the modifications we have to do in CLR1 to get the LLR1? Because in CLR1, as we know, we have generated how many states? 0 to 9, means 10 states are generated in CLR1. So it is quite more, or you can see it is a having more number of states, so processing time will be more, it will take more time. So that's why this in this LLR1 we are going to reduce it, because it is a problem and how we have to solve that. So these states are having some you can observe here some of the states I have written. So I3 from previous CLR1 video, you can get, or from that state transition diagram, some of the states we have taken here, that is I3, I6, I4, I7, I8, I9. So I3, I6, why we have considered these two states here? Because these two states are having same production rules, only difference is in look ahead. Here look ahead is A/B, here look ahead is dollar, except that complete production rules or available rules are same in both of the states. Both states are same, but they are differ from only look ahead, means look aheads are different only. Because of these, only because of this, in CLR1 states are increased, but it should be reduced, right? And but how to reduce it? We will use one technique, but which technique and how we are going to apply any of the technique to reduce that? So we will consider states whose LR0 items are same and only look aheads are different. Okay, so we have considered states where their LR0 items are same, only look aheads are different. Okay, these states we are going to consider in LLR1 further. Okay, up to CLR1 state transition plus table, it is having a same table with action column and go to column. Only which states we are going to consider here, whose LR0 items are same but difference in their look aheads. So we'll consider only those states. After that we have to merge them to generate new state. So how to merge them and how to generate, consider this is I3 and I6, right? So these I3 and I6, we merge it and we'll get the new one state, that is I36. Okay, same way we are going to merge I4 and I7. See here, I4 and I7, T tends to B dot, T tends to B dot dollar, here AB, and we'll get, after merging both of them, we'll get the I47. This 4 and 7 is combined. We will reflect them into parsing table. Okay, whatever newly generated states, next one is the I8 and I9, that is we'll get the I89. These states we are going to reflect in your parsing table. So as we can see in first row, that is row 0, the table values are nothing but S3, S4, 1, 2. So 3 will be merged with 6 and 4 will be merged with, 4 is been merged with 7. So it will look like S36, S47, 1 and 2. Same as it is, because 1 and 2 we are not going to merge. Okay, afterwards, which will be the second row? First row, there is no number, it is accepted. So second row, S6 and 7. Again, 6 is not only separate state now, it is a 36. Okay, state 36, that's why we have written S36 and S47. Okay, and 5 is as it is. After that, same way we are going to do. Here, as you see, 8. Okay, here is 8, row 3. On in T column, there is a 8. But now there is no separate state as 8, or 8 number state is not a separate one now. It is merged with 9. So it should be reflected like 8, 9. Same way we have done here, S36, S47, 8, 9. Again, these are the other ones, the reduce moves. Same way we are going to change our row numbers also. Here row number 3 will be reflected as a 36. Row number 4 will be reflected or will be replaced by 47. Again, 6 will be replaced by 36 and 7 will be replaced by 47, 8, 9 and 8, 9. Okay, all these changes we have done. But what happens here, as you can see, some of the values are duplicated or some of the rows having same values, like 36 row is having S36, S47, 8, 9. And again here, row 36, S36, S47, 8, 9. So it should be reflected only one time in your table. We have to reduce it. So we will delete that row. Again, same way, this row will be deleted. But other rows are, cannot be, we cannot remove them. But what about the reduce moves? Again, 47 and 47 having reduce moves. So R3 is in column AB, but in next 36 row, as you can next 5th number row, or you can say 47 row, you can see here R3 is in dollar column. So this R3 we are going to write in dollar column so that its meaning will be intact and this row can be removed. Same way 89 and 89, R2 is in A and B column. So we can, and 8, 9, another one row where R2 is in dollar column. So this R2 will be written in dollar column upside or upper upside row, and last one row will be deleted. So how your table will look like? Your table will look like this. Okay, means it will be reduced in this fashion. So from your state 0 to 9, you will get the states 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 means 0 to 6, or 7 states. 3 states are reduced. So you can save space and processing time. So as you can make changes, and this is nothing but your LALR parsing table, which is very simple one. And from as you can observe here, as you can observe, these states, number of states required for LR0 in previous video, SLR0 in previous video, and in this video LLR1 will require the 7 states only. Same example we are referring for all of the parsing, different parsing techniques we are using the same example, but they will require only 7 states. Only CLR1 will require the more number of states, that is 10. So you can say that LR0, SLR0, LLR1 having less number or equal number of states to CLR1, number of states. These are nothing but the number of states. So it may have equal number of states or more number of states than these three parsing techniques, that is LR0, SLR0, LLR1. I hope you are getting the LLR1 parsing and how to generate this parsing table, how to reduce, how to merge these states. Thank you.